Hello students, this is your Maths 1 online teaching session. Let us continue with our 6th chapter, that is statistics. In this session, I will be teaching you the last central tendency, that is mode. We have finished with median and mean in the earlier sessions. Let us understand the concept of mode. The score repeating maximum number of times in a data is called as a mode of the class. Now, suppose I give you an example like 3. 3, 7, 7, 8, 8, 8, 9, 10, 12. These are the observations. Okay. Now, which is the number which is repeating maximum times? Just have a look. 3 is repeated 2 times. 7 is repeated 2 times. But 8 is repeating itself 3 times. Correct? So, this is the meaning of the definition, that the score repeating maximum number of times. So, mode for this given observation is... mode for this given observation will be that particular number which is repeated maximum times, which is that 8. I hope you are understanding and recollecting this concept you have learned in 9th standard. This is easy to understand when the given observations are ungrouped. But what if the observations are grouped? Then we have a formula for finding mode for group frequency table. This is what we are going to learn in this session. And the formula is mode is equal to L plus F1 minus F0 upon 2F1 minus F0 minus F2 into H. Do not worry, it is not difficult. F1 minus F0, with what you are starting? F1, right? Then continue. 2F1 minus F0 minus F2 into H. So, this is a formula to be remembered for mode. Now, I will explain each and every term that is used in this. L is nothing but the lower class limit of the modal class. If you remember, I have told you the method how to find median class. There is a method to find modal class also, I'll tell you. Once I know the modal class, the lower limit of that modal class is nothing but this capital L, which is used in the formula. So, L represents the lower limit of the modal class. Then, F1 represents the frequency of the modal class. Then, these two, F0 and F2 represents frequency of the class preceding the modal class, just above the modal class, and F2 represents the frequency of the class succeeding the modal class, just below the modal class. Okay. Again, I am repeating the formula. Mode is equal to L plus F1 minus F0, 2F1 minus F0 minus F2 into H. H is the width or range of the class. As I have told you, any class interval given, upper limit minus lower limit will give you the value of H. Okay, so these are the terms that are used in the formula. L plus F1 minus F0, 2F1 minus F0 minus F2 into H. Okay, so using this formula, I will be explaining you how to find the value of mode. This is a question from the practice set. Let's see the first question. The following table shows the information regarding milk collected from farmers on milk collection center and the content of fat in the milk measured by lactometer. Find the mode of the fat content. Okay. Now see how this mean median mode is used in our day-to-day life. Let's see what is the question given. Content of fat. It is given in the form of class intervals. Correct. Milk collected in liters is 30, 70, 80 and so on. Question asks is to find the mode of the fat content. Right. Now, as I have told you, what is the definition of the word mode? The number having maximum frequency. Now, which is the number having maximum frequency here? 80. Correct? As in median, n upon 2 value was determining the median class. In mode, the maximum frequency will determine my modal class. Okay? So, which is the maximum frequency here? 80. So, this is my modal class. Which one? 4 to 5. I hope you are understanding how to get the modal class. This is maximum frequency, as you can see. 80 is the maximum frequency. It corresponds to 4 to 5. Therefore, the class 4 to 5 is my modal class. If I am able to find out this, half of the work is done. I know what is F1, F2, how to find out that F0, okay, and L value also. All depends upon the modal class. That is very important to understand. The number corresponding to the maximum frequency, the class interval corresponding to the maximum frequency is the modal class. Okay, so let's see. This we have to write in tabular column as it is given vertically. Now in this, as I have told you, class maximum frequency is 80, so the molar class is 4 to 5. Okay, represent that in the table that this is a molar class, highlight it. Then depending on this, as I have told you, the notations now. The frequency of the molar class is nothing but F1. The frequency of the class just above the molar class, this one, will be F0. The frequency of the class just below the molar class, this one, will be F2. Okay? Now, how will you remember? If you write F1 here and F2 here, it is definitely going to go wrong. A clue or a hint to remember, it is in order. See the sequence. First is 0, then 1, and then 2. Okay? This is just a small hint to remember. How to remember this? F1, I have told you, is the frequency of the molar class. Just above it, whatever is the frequency, that will be F0. Succeeding the molar class. Yes, preceding is F0, succeeding is F2. So, like this, we can get all the values. L is the lower limit of the molar class, which is represented here, that is 4. What is the value of H then? H is width, that is upper limit minus lower limit. H is 5 minus 4, that is 1. So, all values I have given you in this table and the formula as well. Now, what you need to do is write the formula, put it in a box. This is a way you will present even in board exam. Okay? So, whenever you are writing formula, have the habit of putting it in a box. So, mod is equal to L plus F1 minus F0 upon 2F1. Minus F0 minus F2 into H. Right? Now, all these values I have shown you in the table. What you need is to just substitute the values. L was 4, as a molar class was 4 to 5, lower limit is 4. F1 80, F0 70. Substitute here 2 into F1, 2 into 80, minus 70, minus 60. H I have explained, it is 1. Okay? Now, let's see the solution of it. 80 minus 70 will give me 10. Right? Now, 80 into 2 is 160. 70 and 60 is 130. So, 160 minus 130 into 1, even if I don't write, it is understood. So, 10 upon 30, then what can be done? First of all, the zeros can be cancelled, or 10 upon, yes, this 0 and the 0 can be cancelled. 1 upon 3, you can divide it and write it as 0.33. Okay? Correct up to 2-digit decimal point. So, 4 plus 0.33 is nothing but 4.33. Okay, this was what mode for percentage of fat. So final answer will be the mode of fat content is 4.33%. I hope all the steps are clear to you. What is the basic thing to remember? For mode, we have to concentrate for maximum frequency, that is F1. Maximum frequency just above that will be F0. Below the maximum frequency will be F2. Like that, we have to find the values of the things required for the formula. L will be lower limit of the molar class. H will be the width of the molar class. Okay. So, like this, you can substitute and get the answer. Write it fast. We move on to the next question. The next question is the third one. Group frequency distribution of supply of milk to hotels and the number of hotels is given in the following table. Find the mode of the supply of milk. Exactly same type. These are very easy sums provided you remember the formula. Okay. So, let's see the question. This is the table. Again, continuous classes are given. Again, I am telling you, if the classes are not continuous, compulsory you have to make it continuous. Otherwise, you will get it wrong. In this question also, it is continuous. So, no problem like that. Directly, we can use the table, draw it in fact in a vertical way. Yes. Now, let us decide all the values first and understand it properly, then use the formula and solve it. First thing, when you have the table in front of you, you need to search for maximum frequency. Where is it? Here, 35. 35 is the maximum frequency. It means that 9 to 11 will be my modal class. I hope you understood the first step, how to decide the modal class. Maximum frequency is 35. So, 9 to 11 is the modal class. Maximum frequency always corresponds to F1. Above it means the preceding frequency is F0. Succeeding frequency is F2. Okay. Now, this 9 to 11 is the modal class. So, what is the value of L? That is lower limit. As you can see here, lower limit of the modal class is 9. What is the value of H? That is width of the class or range of the class? 11 minus 9. Yes, upper limit minus lower limit. 11 minus 9, that is 2. So, all values for the formula I have given you. L I have given, F0, F1, F2, H. Okay. Now what is left? We need to substitute the values and get the answer. Before that, we will highlight everything in the table itself. First thing, the maximum frequency is 35. So the modal class is 9 to 11. Highlight it in the figure. In the table, yes. So 9 to 11 is a modal class. Then frequency of the modal class, that is F1, is 35. Above it will be F0, that is 20. Below it will be F2, that is 18. As I have shown you, exactly same way I have indicated everything here. What is H? H I have shown you that it is 2. Same way use the formula. Formula is mod is equal to L plus F1 minus F0 upon 2F1 minus F0 minus F2 into H. By now, I hope you have learned the formula also. FL plus F1 minus F0 2F1 minus F0 minus F2 into H. Okay. Now let's substitute the values as shown here. That is L is equal to 9. F1 is 35. F0 is 20. Now substituting in the denominator, it is 2 into F1. So 2 into 35 minus 20 minus 18 into 2. H was 2. Okay. Now let us simplify it. 35 minus 20 is 15. Correct? So 15, 2 into 35 is 70, 20 and 18 when we add it, because both are with minus sign, so we need to add it. So minus minus will remain minus, and 20 plus 18 is 38. So 70 minus 38 is 32, right? Okay, so 15 upon 32 into 2. Now what we will do is we will cancel this. 2 ones are and 2 16s are. Okay, so 9 plus 15 upon 16. This is what we will get. When we divide this correctly up to 3 digit decimal point, we get 0.937. Now the third digit is 7, which is greater than 5. So we will increase the previous one by 1. I hope you know rounding up, that this 7, it is greater than 5. So this will become 4. So this becomes 9 plus 0.937. Yes, 0.9. Now this 3, I will make it as 4. So this becomes 9 plus 0.94, which is nothing but 0.94. Here only you round it up, or you add it and then round it up, no problem at all. As you wish, you can do it. So the answer is approximately equal to 9.94. So the mode of the supply of milk is 9.94 liters approximately. I hope this concept is clear to you. Okay. So with this, I come to the end of this session. In this session, I have explained you all the important things that you need to know about mode and two sums, how to calculate mode. I hope you have understood. We'll meet in the next session. Thank you.